Beau.
And I'm Kara.
And our house is our biggest art project to date.
And we'll show you how we take care of ours.
All of it. Anyways. Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode. This episode is going to be a homeowner episode. Scary. In this episode, we are going to install a bidet. If you don't know what a bidet is, it's a nice little stream of water that cleans out your butthole. I have an audience today.
When you say butthole, you could just say your bum.
You know all the stuff they say on this box? What? The Heine Shiner, the first bidet for the rest of your life, your new butt buddy, the butt kisser. But I'm the bad guy. But anyways, we bought a Hello Tushy. Make sure you say Hello Tushy and not Tushy. Because if you go to HelloTushy.com, you'll get the bidet. If you go to Tushy.com, you'll get a very special website. But in the box, you will get a hot water hose, a cold water hose, the actual Tushy attachment. This goes under your toilet seat. We got one with the bamboo knobs because it goes with our bamboo wood flooring.
Which is good for
water.
Well, no, it's meant for damp areas.
Oh, meant for damp areas, like your butt. You have a special little fitting that attaches to this end. This is for a toilet because it's plastic and it has a big threaded nut. Again, bathroom humor. And they also give you a little brass plug. That is in case you use their special tea, but you don't need the water to come out two different directions. You can simply cap it, and then the water only goes out of one direction. And then they also give you this delightfully inappropriate book, and it's like chapter 7, the history of cleaning your butt. It's like myth number 1, isn't dirty toilet water you're spraying in your butt with? No, it's not. It's clean water. It's the same water that goes in the tank. So I'm going to show you what the prep work that I have to do because we bought a special one. If you normally buy a Tushy, you just have to do the cold water. But since we're right above the mechanical room in the basement, I have access to my hot water pipe. So we're going to have hot and cold water. So it's more difficult. Let me show you how we do it. Here is our toilet. This is where our bidet is going to be installed. And if it is just the cold water, it's real easy because you have cold water going from there to your tank. We have a hot water option. The hot water is underneath the toilet in the mechanical room in the basement. So in order to get to the hot water, I had to take off a piece of trim, which is here, and I had to drill a hole for the hot water to come up. I also made a little room in case I need a bend on my hot water pipe. So let us go down in the basement to figure out how to get the hot water up here.
Where's the basement?
Upstairs!
Up to the basement!
To the basement!
To the basement!
Up in that big menagerie of pipes, that's where we have to go for our plumbing. Right there is where we have to come out for the hot water, but we have to connect it to right there. So we have to go from that pipe to that space. But then to make things more complicated, I have that pipe, which I want to connect hot water to because that goes to our downstairs bathroom. So I have to connect that pipe to that pipe, which will then go to our new bidet, which is over there. Here are some of the tools that you might need for this job. One, of course, is fittings. We have copper fittings and some specialty shark bite fittings because our house has plastic pipe, but I like to do things in copper. We have some hangers, some water shutoff valves, a hammer, torch, emery cloth, PEX tubing cutter, copper tubing cutter, and a brush fitting in case you need one. If you have emery cloth, you're still good. What's not listed here is some flux and some solder. So way up here, not that you can see too much, that's where the toilet is. So I had to come down with the hose, and this is where I'm hooking up to it. Most people won't have this type of fitting. This is just what the plumbers left us when they built the house. So that's how I'm attaching it to it. If it was just this, it'd be easy, but knowing us, it's not. But we have to shut off the hot water, drain the hot water, make a cut, hook everything up, and then hope it doesn't leak.
And what's that fitting in your hand?
It's a shark bite fitting. It can connect to anything that is the half inch. So if it's PVC, CPVC, copper, brass, PEX,
It'll connect to everything because it's like $15 freaking fitting. Don't screw it up. Now to doing it. Wow. That was easy.
That was uneventful. I thought it was going to come pouring out.
Well, there you go. That's how you drain the hot water.
It's not even a teaspoon.
Not even a drop.
Yeah. That's over. Like, it's like a 6 gallon pail.
Lost my fitting.
Your $15 fitting?
Yeah, lost it.
You just said don't screw it up.
Oh, found it.
Oh, Hey. My feet are wet.
Now this fitting, all we should have to do, can you get any closer? Now all we really should have to do is just stick that in there. There. Installed. Leak proof.
Take the gas pipe.
Yeah, take the gas pipe.
If you have anything with metal threads, you should put some Teflon tape on it, and that's this little white plumbing tape. You don't really need it because it has a washer, so I'm just gonna put Teflon tape on everything. And it is your leak proofing. Once you have the bolts off, you just take off the cover, put that on, adjust your huge washers.
Is that what that is?
Yeah. Wow. So that way you can put your toilet seat back on. There. Yes, you do have to put this on before you can hook up your water, because the water gets hooked up to this. And you don't want this floating around with water pressure. So what you have to do is you have to shut off the water, empty the tank, and then take the hose off the tank. And then you have this fitting. The hose from the tank goes into here. That part goes on the tank. And then from the tushy to the cold water goes to here. And then this goes from the tushy cold water, which is here underneath. You can't see because it's my secret. It's my dirty secret. And there's two different types of ports. One says cold, so that's where it goes. And then you just loop it over here and try to make it pretty. And then everything is hand tight. So then you just tighten it a little bit.
How can plumbers be bigger than you? I don't understand how they fit.
That's where the apprentices come in.
God.
The apprentices are skinny. So you don't have to over tighten the stuff. But it's nice just to snug it up with a wrench. Fish.
Shrimp out of it.
So let's see if I have any leaks in the cold. Nope. No leaks. So now I'm gonna fish my hot water. This is the weird part because there's no instructions on how to make it work with trim. And the hot water, we should just push because that is one of the special fittings. Okay, now we are going to turn on the hot water that goes to our new bidet, and then we can see if we have any leaks.
Ah, stop!
Is it leaking?
Yeah!
We're leaking. Okay.
Was it looser?
No, I just didn't have it pressed in the entire way.
Oh, no, it was like a good sprinkler.
Our hot water. No leaks.
You gotta try it with the lid up though, dude. Oh. Ah! Wow!
Okay, this is the real test. It works. And it is warm. And you can get some high pressure. That's kind of fun. How does cold water feel like? Keep it on that hot water. Success. How was it?
It was refreshing.
On a hot summer day.
And weird, but you do feel a lot cleaner than just using paper. All we need is a dryer on it, then you don't have to use paper at all.
I'll get on that. Well, I hope you learned on how to install a hot water Hello Tushy Bidet. It's not an easy thing, especially depending upon where your hot water lines are, but it is doable as we've seen. If you ever done something like that, leave us a comment below, because we don't know of anybody that actually did a hot water one. We've seen cold water ones, but not hot water ones. But anyways, thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next time. Bye.